snowy, but we're in the shade. Mel and Trudy again from Kooyong Classic, doing our wrap up at the end of a great day, at the end of day one. As you can see, we're a bit shaded because it has been a gorgeous day, but pretty hot. So yeah, we're done with sun. We're sitting slip, slop, slap kind of stuff now. Hey, Jeannie. How's your day, Trude?
It's pretty awesome. One of the really good things about Kooyong is you get really close to all the players and the action. So that was pretty exciting. I almost fell over Nico and Mel before.
Yes, you did. I couldn't witness to that.
That doesn't happen at the Australian Open. So it's a pretty exciting thing about Kooyong.
Yeah, that was interesting, wasn't it? Like, he was just walking down here with no people around. And what about, you know, when Pat Cash walked out?
Yeah, so Pat Cash just walked out before no one around him, except for the moment where he actually put his headband on and then people
seemed to flock to him. Yeah, we're like, oh, there's Pat Cash. Oh, yeah, and then headband on, suddenly everyone, there's Pat Cash. So clearly the headband is a key part.
Not something you'd wear if you're trying to be conspicuous.
So today we've had three matches of tennis. So the first one was Lopez versus Gilles Simon, which Lopez won in the tiebreak.
Yeah, so it's a three-set tiebreak here, best of 10, leading by two.
Yep, and I think Lopez was pretty cute in his press conference. Well, he's always pretty cute, let's be honest. But it's really good what they're doing there, having the press conferences out here in Kooyong Common, and all the kids sit up the front and they hand a microphone around so anyone can ask anyone a question. And one of the kids came up with, so, how did you feel when you were 8-5 down in the third set tiebreak? To which Lopez's answer was, that's a really good question. So that was really cute.
I think he said, I didn't feel great.
But he did start with, that's a good question. And then I thought I'd lost it or something like that. He also talked about how it's such a change in conditions from when he was in Doha. Oh, sorry, that was my finger. He was in Doha. It's quite tiring. My arm's been holding up a lot of pressure. Oh, true. There you go. Lovely jubbly. Just the changing conditions coming from Doha, where it was cooler, to Melbourne. But to be honest, I think that's why people love playing Kooyong, because they can really settle in to Melbourne conditions. So that was the first match. And then we had Hyun Chung versus Australia's Omar Jasika. Chung from Korea. He actually got an ATP award for, I think it was most improved last year. Looked really impressive to me. It was
best
a good
newcomer.
Match. Was it best newcomer or one of them? It looked really impressive to me, so I would be looking out for him. That's your finger there as well.
Sorry.
looking out for him at Australian Open. Hey guys, if you've just joined, send us some hearts. And we're happy to answer any questions that you've got about the Kooyong Classic as well. So that was the second match. Chung won. That was straight sets, that one?
Yes, it's 6-4, 6-3.
Yeah, and then third up we had Nicolas Almagro and Paul-Henri Mathieu. To be honest, that was probably the best quality match of the day. Almagro took him a while to settle in, but just hitting really strongly. I think he's going to be in good form coming into next week as well.
So I'm pretty sure the gates open around 10 o'clock tomorrow.
Yes.
But the play starts at 11, so if you get in here early.
How old are you? Can we ask why you're asking? Do we look old or do we look particularly young?
And if we say we look old, we're just going to say the light's not very flattering.
Yeah, we're older than we look. Is that the right thing to say?
Older than we look or younger?
Do you want me to take it over? Yeah. How's your arm going? We learned how good you have to be to camera person to hold a whole iPhone for a press conference while you're looking for
If you head back and you see, we filmed on Periscope a couple of the press conferences, so I apologise in advance if you're going to watch those now, because they are a little bit shaky.
But we're building up our arm strength for the next 3 days. We might get like something.
Get really a selfie stick. I actually kind of have one. Never used it.
And you can probably hear, hopefully you can hear in the background the music. So they've got live music here every night, cover bands.
Pretty cool live music actually. Yeah. These guys have done a mixture of Michael Jackson, Pearl Jam, INXS. Just really relaxed and chill.
You have a selfie stick, please bring it, Jeannie. Someone needs to be organised in this family. Does anyone else have any questions about Kooyong? So in the meantime, we might just go over who's got playing tomorrow.
Okay.
So
tomorrow, first match.
Thanks, Jay.
First match is Marcos Baghdatis versus Pablo Carreño Busta.
Thanks for joining.
Hi, Linda.
Yeah, look, I love watching Baghdatis play. To be honest, he's one of my kind of top... He's not my absolute top. Clearly, Rafa's got that position for life. But Baghdatis, I just think he's really entertaining to play. I actually saw him in Nottingham earlier this year. So looking forward, that should be a good matchup for
and
them.
I think the other thing is Baghdatis is actually really popular here in Australia, particularly Melbourne.
Yeah, he's kind of adopted, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. We have a really big Greek community here as well, so the Greeks and Cypriots really get on board and support him. So that should be pretty good from a crowd perspective.
So they're up first, and then next, after that, we've got Kyrgios, who's playing... Oh yeah, David Goffin, who is really good to watch as well. You guys probably watched Hopman Cup last week. I thought Nick was amazing, to be honest.
Really impressive.
And if there was ever any doubt that he's an awesome tennis player, it should be all out of everyone's mind now.
Yep.
He also went to the Fast Four tennis match last night, representing Australia. I just think... To be honest, there's been no controversy, has there?
I think it's...
Not like it's been in weeks and there's been no controversy or anything. So, you know, I think that leads him in well.
Yeah, so he'll be, hitting his third state in a week. So we're sure he's probably going to be pretty jet-lagged and pretty tired, but we think he's probably going to give it his all.
And I'm guessing there'll be a big crowd here to support him. That'll be a fun match to watch. That's the second one.
Third is actually... Omar, who we saw today, is playing an exhibition match against Kei Nishikori, which should be a pretty good one.
Yeah, I mean, they've done well, haven't they, pulling Nishikori into the lineup. He's played here in the past, and I think he was pretty happy just to get a Melbourne hard court match in before next week.
Yeah.
There's more.
There's one more match for tomorrow. So it's Alex Zverev versus Kyle Edmund. So another two of the young guys up. It should be pretty exciting because I haven't seen either of those guys play live. So, yeah, pretty exciting.
But I think they've done well. So Zverev played for Germany in the Hopman Cup last week. And Kyle Edmund, I think, reached a quarterfinal against Berdych.
He did pretty well as well at the Davis Cup. So
again, another interesting matchup. It is going to be, what can we say, pretty hot tomorrow.
42 degrees Celsius. It's going to be really warm. I'm pretty sure I'm already burnt from today.
We're going to go home soon actually and rehydrate and get cool. But you know what, we're good in Australia at keeping cool. So it will be hot, but there's shade here. There's places you can sit. Just bring plenty of water when you come.
Yeah.
Sunscreen up. Do all the sensible things.
And slip, slop, slap.
Yeah, we'll be doing that. Between 11 and 3, sit under a tree or something something of that nature.
Pretty poetic. Between 11 and 3, sit under a tree.
So Trish, shall we just give them a little look around? Like we said, you can hear the band. We might just give you a little look around.
Yeah.
Kuyong Common and the people chilling.
So we're just going to flip the camera around now.
So everyone's chilling a bit. There was a huge crowd over here earlier. Pat Cash was playing tennis with Ada Nikudamu, how you say her name. She was from Home and Away. She was actually married on Home and Away to Vinny, who's Ryan Quanton, who
you might know
American
from
people know from True Blood,
who
has a very good stomach muscles. Anyway, that's. I'll show you right round as well because there's the stadium, so that's centre court where the matches are. You can see how nice it's all laid out. There's a members lounge around here, people chilling out having lunch. And then we go around to here. Here's the Priceline Lounge where they're doing all sorts of free stuff. Oh, we forgot to show our nails as well, Trude. If you come to the Priceline Lounge when you're here, there's all sorts of things you can access just for a charity donation. And we're going to show how nice. Oh, hang the right. Yeah, you can't see them, but anyway, trust us, our nails look really nice, so if you do come down, get in there, you can get a massage, beauty treatment.
Shout out
to Metro. Your temperature's 3 degrees C. What? Okay, we're sending you some heat from tomorrow because we don't need all that we've got.
Pretty cool to see the comp winners from our competitions as well, posting photos from around the ground, so we'll probably share some of those tonight and then tomorrow as well.
Yeah, awesome.
Got some of our other comp winners coming in, so if you are one of our comp winners, make sure you send us some of your pics.
Yeah,
and
let
them.
Us know if you want to say hi as well when you come down here. So
yeah, we're always floating around.
Yeah, all right, well, thanks again. That's our day one wrap up. We will be back tomorrow.
That we will.
Yay. Thanks, guys. Thanks for all your comments and everything. And if you do have questions later, send them on Twitter, Instagram, wherever we are. We're happy to answer them.
And we know that last time on our very first Periscope, which was probably not that
we
great.
We shan't speak of it. We're not speaking of it everyone, anymore. I blocked it out.
Everyone really enjoyed Thanks, apparently Linda. Listening to our Aussie accent. So if you guys want to know or us to translate any of the Aussie words, let us know.
Oh, yeah, we'll do some of that tomorrow. Yeah, awesome. We might ask on Twitter what they want to hear us say, and we're all in for that. But we can finish with how to say Melbourne.
Melbourne.
So, Trudy, how many syllables in Melbourne?
Two.
What's the first one?
Mel.
As in my name?
Yep.
Mel. And what's the second one?
Bin.
As in where you put rubbish. Not born, as in what happens when you come into the
Not
world.
Not Jason Bourne.
So, Mel. Bin. All right, on that pleasant note, we'll leave you guys and see you tomorrow.